What is the best and most effective way to use breakout rooms to teach when working in Zoom? In this video, I'm going to take you through the latest updates. You can now screen share from the main room into the breakout rooms. I'm going to show you a couple of little tricks and a couple of things to keep in mind when you do that. I'm also going to show you some other techniques that can help to make the breakout rooms really interactive. This session is full of ideas that if you're a teacher, you'll be able to use with your students. Really hope you like the video. As always, if you do, please like it, please share it with other teachers, and please, of course, comment on it. I'd love to know which technique you like the best. Let's get started. So let me start by immediately showing you the new update where you can share into breakout rooms, and I'll also point out a few problems. I've used it a few times and there are a couple of things to think about. If we first of all just screen share normally, you'll notice that you don't have the option here to screen share to breakout rooms. I can obviously choose whatever window I want to screen share, but I can't screen share to breakout rooms. However, as soon as I create breakout rooms, so let's create for ourselves three breakout rooms, and we're going to automatically assign those breakout rooms. We click on create, and then we need to actually open the breakout rooms. Now, as soon as I open the breakout rooms, so now there are three rooms. Obviously, I haven't got any students in the rooms, but that doesn't matter. What happens now is if I click on screen share, I get the option to share to breakout rooms. Now, what I'm going to do now is show you what you can share to breakout rooms, because you can't share everything to breakout rooms. Just a super quick tip to keep in mind when you're doing this. Click on this button here, we'll do down here on the left, and go to the audio settings and then choose screen share. Make sure you've got this clicked, share all sharing options, show all sharing options, because you want to be able to share a variety of things. If you have these two selected, then what will happen is when the students are in the breakout rooms and you screen share, automatically the students are going to see your desktop. So always make sure that those two buttons are clicked on. Now let's get back then to now looking at what options then you've got. As long as you choose that option of you can share all the options, what options have you got to screen share? So my first tip is screen share. Make sure you've got this button clicked and use the interactive whiteboard. It works really well. I tested it the other day, both as a student and as a teacher. And as soon as I screen share, now everyone in the breakout rooms, in all the breakout rooms, will see this. So what I can do is pre-prepare some questions that I want the students to discuss in groups. And this is exactly what I did the other day. I had a lesson. I started the lesson. I said, right, you watched a video for homework. I now want you to discuss these questions regarding the video. I put them into breakout rooms, screen shared the interactive whiteboard, and immediately they've got access to the questions. Now, if you start writing on the interactive whiteboard, that will also appear in the breakout rooms, and we tested this and it worked perfectly. Now, you can also share websites into the breakout rooms. Again, click on the share button. Obviously, the students must be in breakout rooms first. This button does not appear unless you've already put the students into breakout rooms. Make sure that button's selected. And this time, we're going to click here and we're going to share a website. Now, we tested this again and worked absolutely fine. The students immediately see whatever you share. And remember, when you share a particular technology, so for example, in this case, I'm choosing Google Chrome. If I jump between the Google Chrome tabs, because I'm still in the same technology, so I'm still sharing Google Chrome, then the students see that absolutely perfectly. Again, we tested this and we were jumping between tabs within the same technology and it worked perfectly. Now, we also tested screen sharing PowerPoint, and I just want to point out, if I click on a PowerPoint, click on it again, so I'm screen sharing it. Now, I normally move into full screen mode by clicking the button here. Don't forget you need to click onto the screen to reactivate the PowerPoint slides, but this worked perfectly. And as I flicked through the slides, the students in the room saw the different slides that I was presenting. So again, PowerPoint works really well, and that could be interesting if you want to prolong a discussion, because what you can do is have several questions, perhaps one question on page one, one page on two, page three, a few questions, and that way you can kind of start with a question in the breakout room, then open up another question into the breakout room, so you can move through the slides and your students will see all of the slides you share. Remember, you can't add your audio though, so you can't talk over the slides, only the students can watch the slides. Okay, so we've looked at the new rule about breakout rooms, but I want to now just go through a couple of the problems when you're using the breakout rooms and just make it really clear there are some obstacles to the new system. So let's now focus on some of those problems. Now, the next piece of news I've got for you is that you can share video, despite it kind of saying that you can't. You can share video, but I want to make it clear you can't share sound. And I'm just going to show you why. Look what happens. If I turn this off so I don't share into breakout rooms, I now have the option to optimize for video clip and to share sound. As soon as I share into a breakout room, I don't get those sound options. However, if I click on a video that's on YouTube, so I've got a video that's from Google Chrome, and I click on share, click on the button here, then obviously the best thing I normally do is to put it into cinema mode or into full screen and play this video. The students will see this video, but they will not hear the audio. That's the important thing to remember. We tested it out. The students could clearly see the video. What they couldn't do was hear the audio. So that's a really important thing to remember. You can share a video from YouTube, but what you can't do is share the audio from YouTube. Just a super quick break just to say, if you like the video, please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Loads more free videos on using different technologies for teaching. There's a special section on Zoom. And if you want to follow my work, the best thing to do is to sign up to the newsletter. That way you'll get updated with all the latest videos, the blogs, the webinars, and the online courses. And at this moment, we're offering a 12-part free training series, video training series on using technology in teaching, and I send you a video about every 4 or 5 days. Right, let's get back to the Zoom training. Now, interestingly, we found the answer to the first problem that we were having. When we were doing the tests, we couldn't work out how can we send a message into the breakout rooms if we're screen sharing, because we don't have access to the breakout rooms button. However, if you roll over, click on more. So if you come over to here, click on more, open up the breakout rooms. You can then go to the message and send the students a message, send a message. So even though you're screen sharing and the students are obviously looking at the PowerPoint slide, you can actually send a message into the breakout rooms. And the other thing that you can do is it does mean that you can move people around. Obviously, normally you would have different people in here. Remember, you can roll over someone's name and move them to another room. So you can control the breakout rooms even when you are screen sharing. And at the beginning, we didn't realize that. And when we were doing the tests, we kept stop screen sharing and then going to the breakout rooms button and opening up and sending a message. We now realize you can still access the breakout rooms button when you're screen sharing. Another thing that you can't do, and if we click on the screen share button, again, we've got the breakout rooms, so we've got that option to share into the breakout rooms, is that you can't share your webcam into the breakout rooms. The webcams do not work. So you don't have the option, for example, of when the students are in the breakout rooms, of turning on your webcam and giving them a message. A, they can't hear your audio. B, they can't see your webcam. You can play video from YouTube, remember, but remember again, the audio will not work. So what I'm going to do for this final bit is just show you some other techniques that you might want to think about when working with breakout rooms that I've used a lot and have worked really well for me. Now, I do lots of training with organizations to help them to work with Zoom and different ideas. And I just want to show you this one here that I use with Google Docs that works really well. Now, this is an actual example. If you look here, what I did was, and I'll take you right through this, is I created a Google Doc before I put the students into breakout rooms. I shared that Google Doc in the chat window, and so that when the students went into breakout rooms, only one student had to do the writing. One student in each room would then screen share the Google Doc, and students could discuss things together and write up their answers. And so here's room one. This is what they've written, and their leader was Sylvia. And if I come down here to group two, you'll see the same thing. We've got Gerard in room two, and Gerard's been writing for that group. Now, I'm going to show you how I did this because it's a great technique. And sometimes when I'm training teachers, they get slightly confused. So I'll take you right through how you do this. So let me take you through this process because it really is a great technique and it's one I use all the time. You need to go to your Google Drive, and the reason I like it is that you're creating one document. All the students in all the breakout rooms are working on that same document, and then you've got all the information in one place. So just go to your Google Drive, click on New, click on Google Docs. When you open up your Google Docs, remember always, first of all, to give the Google Doc a name just so that you can easily find it. So I'm going to just call this one, let's just quickly call it Discuss. And then I'm going to come down to here. I'm going to write in now the question. So I'm going to say to the students, Discuss the new Zoom features. Okay, so obviously, what I've been showing you today is one of the new features that's been introduced. Now, what I also do then is click on Insert. Now, let's imagine that I know I'm going to have five breakout rooms. So I come to the table, and what I'll do is I'll create two columns, and you'll see why, and I'm going to create six down. Okay, so basically six across. Now, I'll move the box this way, and then I just put group name here or group here, and then ideas here. So now what I normally do is create some space, so make it absolutely clear that this is where group one are going to add their information. This is where group two are going to add their information. This is where group three are. Okay, so I've got it nicely prepared. I've got all the areas where the students are going to write. Now this is the really important thing. Come over to the share button. Come down here, click on change, and make sure that you've got this set to everybody can edit. Normally it will be in everyone can view. So set it to everyone can edit. Click on done. Okay, in fact, sorry, there's one other button that you should click on before you do that. Click on copy link because you want to have a copy of that link. That is really important. Now, this is the important thing to do. In the breakout rooms, before you put the students into breakout rooms, just share the link with all the students and tell them to click on it so that they will have a copy. Now, when they move into breakout rooms, only one person in the group will need to screen share that document. And the person in the group that screen shares the document will also be able to write into it. So normally when we create breakout rooms, we'll have the numbers of the room, so room one, room two, room three. So obviously the group one will write in the section where you provided for room one, group two will write in the section for group two, and group three will write in the section for group three, etc. Okay, really hope you liked that video. If you want more free videos, please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. There is a special section on Zoom with loads of Zoom videos, and there's also loads of extra training videos around different topics, as well as some of the latest videos on the front page. If you want to follow my work, the best thing to do is to sign up to the newsletter. I keep you updated with all the latest videos, the latest blogs, the latest webinars, and the online courses. But also, at the moment, there is a 12-part free step-by-step training course in using technology. It's completely free, and I send you a video about every 5 days. The other thing, of course, you can do is subscribe to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to click on the bell to get the updates. And if you did want me to do some training with your organization, then please contact me from my website. I'm going to add a few more videos onto the screen now about other Zoom topics that you might find interesting.